it's always some big mouth ass nigga talking shit. It's always some big mouth motherfucker hating. Always a nigga hating. It's always somebody that's displeased with what you do. You can never make motherfuckers happy. It's always somebody unsatisfied that feels entitled. It's always some bitch on the sideline talking shit with her big mouth. It's always some big mouth ass nigga talking shit about what you should have did with your money and what you could have, would have, should have. It's just, you understand me? Big mouth. Your big mouth ass.
You got a big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
Big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
A big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth. A big mouth.
There's a rumor being spread about me and my crew, about something we did or supposed to do. You might not have heard it, or maybe you have, but when I first heard it, all I did was laugh. I used to get angry and all uptight. You can say what you want, just spell my name right, 'cause all I'm ever guilty of is rocking the house. But that's not what the rumor was all about. So if you like to hate, tell all your friends, and if you don't, wait until you see me again. This way I can hear it from the horse's mouth, right then and there we can straighten it out, 'cause I don't get involved with he said, she said. So take my advice and quit while you're here, because one day I just might not laugh or pull up and pop a cap in your ass.
You got a big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
Big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth. Big mouth. You got a big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
A big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth.
Used to say that you got a big mouth. Now I understand what they talking about, because what we do is just between me and you, not something that you run and tell your crew. But you had to tell Sharon and she told Karen, then the story rolled on just like a wheelbarrow. Carol told Dee Dee and she told Pam, and Pebbles overheard her talking to her man. Pam was so quickie what she thought she heard, and somehow my nigga Diddy bopped out the word. He told somebody I knew from Fruit Town. They called me up and put me down. Now the whole damn story's been changed around, and that's the reason why I ain't fucking with you now, 'cause you never should've opened your mouth at all, and I wouldn't have had no reason to make this call.
You got a big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
Big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth. Big mouth. You got a big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
A big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
Big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth. Big mouth. You got a big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
A big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth. A big mouth.
Now you're the dime dropper of the neighborhood, and every time I see you up to no good, just like a snake crawling on the ground, looking for some new dirt to spread around. Now you're the dime dropper of the neighborhood, every time I see you up to no good, just like a snake crawling on the ground, looking for some new dirt to spread around.
You got a big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
Big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth. Big mouth. You got a big mouth.
Yeah, nigga.
A big mouth.
You too.
You got a big mouth.
I can't forget you.
A big mouth.